Evans, you're muted.
Morning, Libby.
Oh, I am not muted. What are you going on
about? I was teaching Libby coding, editing CSS.
Oh, and Pankaz is here as well. Fantastic. Right, can everyone see the screen?
Yes, I can.
What have you got behind you, Peter? Who are you having a lecture from?
Australia.
Oh, no, is that a teacher or a guitarist?
What we've got here, we've got one that's unparented. What
could
is
this
one?
Refresh it? Because I'm not sure why is it this way. I just created those and it should be in place correctly and properly.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the shoot. And they are gone.
Like magic. Okay, right, let's go from the top of the board. Ms. Grevens.
So yesterday was pretty much a facilitation day. I did get the so nothing moving on the top two. I need Pete as my L2 approver. Can you go and have a look at PR for the top the 158857? I need.
Is it PR? Do you have PR on the board?
Unfortunately not. You just not that one. The
next one. 145.
What, the PR or?
I can't read. George, have you got a super high res screen? Your screen looks quite better sometimes. She's got a 2K. Quite something screen. It's nice not coming out sharp on my screen.
Regarding the current hierarchical thing will not work for the data level greater than 1. It will work only for the 0 and 1. If we will go in more hierarchy, it will not work. So I have fixed those bits, and now I'm getting some problem because of we are re-rendering the complete chart on toggling the unit resource. So I'm doing that rather than doing the entire chart re-rendering. I'm doing the focus update on that also. And probably should be done by today.
Okay. I think we're at the point where we are on the verge of crossing over. Dal and I had some conversations yesterday and some thoughts about what I'm now naming the rendering cycle and how things are going to work with the ordinal scale containing all of the row heights. Mm-hmm. Really, what we need is a session today between the three of us, maybe a walkthrough of the direction that you're heading in, just to make sure that we're all in line and see if we can spot anything before it all goes in. So can we make that happen this morning, please?
Yes, we can do that, but can we do it in 2-3 hours, probably, after 2 or 3 hours?
Yeah, I mean, if it suits you, I mean, we could do it. No, say, after lunch, it's 2 o'clock. What's that time difference wise for you, Pankaj?
Yes, it's 2:15 p.m. for me right now.
Then 4.5 hours ahead.
Yes, for 5 hours around.
Could we do that at 12? So in 2.25 hours.
Yes, we can have.
Perfect, right.
Because we still got the retrospective in it, right?
Yes, but that will be done by then.
Yeah, that's okay for you.
That's fine. No, it's better. Okay. Is that alright with you, Dale?
Yeah.
Alright, thank you. Okay, so of these two here, Pankaj, the two that have got 4 tiles in progress, are they all in progress at the same time?
The above 2 are in progress, but today I'm not sure I will be able to continue with this 153679. So for that, on Tuesday, I had a discussion with Dell about what exactly we need on the explicit update report. So I'm clear on that. Once I will be done with this updater thing, we'll pick that up.
Okay. And I've just noticed there's a task here without any hours on it. If you could update that for us, that would be great. Okay, so this is my one here. So again, from another discussion with Dow, we are trying to work out the implications on the DOM of rebinding elements that are halfway down. So let's see what the implications that are, considering if you do that, then its parent element will still be rebound to the original instance of, for example, posting TW resource. So I'm just going to try and do an experiment to see what happens when we do that, and hopefully work out if we actually can. So I'll be moving on to that today. Moving on to the next one.
George, you basically sort of assigned and done the hours.
Well, there's no completing because I pulled it.
Yeah, we just done the hours.
Okay. Thank you.
And hours.
Oh, the main one. Okay. Right, Patrick.
So yesterday we had our discussion about the stuff related to the selection of the tasks, the selection of the resources, which is going to be continued today with Peter, with Dal, and with Netta. So I will most likely move this one to do or even to blocked, because we are needing to have the conversation and then decide how we will proceed. Other than that, I did some cleanup in the diary controller, so not a lot of stuff in there, but a little bit of progress. And then I extracted one which should be at the very bottom. So
I wouldn't bother putting it blocked because we, we've scheduled the meeting and it'll be resolved.
Okay.
So,
let's say it's standard at this point?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So you've got the meeting scheduled, is that right?
Yeah,
yeah. Like 3 o'clock this afternoon.
And sorry, Victor, we skipped over your one there.
No problem. As I still don't have anything ready for test, I'm writing test cases for things that as they're coming. So once there is something, I will switch to testing.
Fantastic. I think he's over there. Test cases coming. A note from me, Joe's put into work today, so I've got the two kids, so I might be a little bit on and off. Hopefully that won't cause too many problems. Lindsay, you on the call?
I am.
So,
I had a chat with Simon yesterday. Good news is, all of the PBIs that we were looking at yesterday, he agrees with for M7. There was just one thing, two things, that we didn't have included in the PBIs. That's the weekend shading and the public holiday shading. So I'll add that in. And we appear to have missed the roster print button on the diary as well. So the question to you guys is, I've managed to ship out the roster report, the roster print report to another team. Do we want them to do the adding the button to the diary, or would you guys feel safer with us doing that ourselves?
Good question. I don't know. I mean, it's not the bit where they add it, it would go up in the roster browse buttons bar, on it, with the weeks and all that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
Which is just standard React, so it shouldn't be difficult for them to add.
Okay, so if I go with that, if they can do it in its entirety, so add the button and the reports, and then obviously if they've got any problems, they'll just come to us and we'll guide them through that.
Yeah, and they'll need Nick's mock-ups, and they'll need either the icon produced or given the details of whatever one it is, if it is already available.
Yeah.
And they'll probably need some help from Blackpool teams where they'll actually be look up the report requesting bits for us. So.
Yes.
Okay.
Work.
Yeah. One of the good things that Simon's agreed is that we don't have to implement the long press for the iPad, because we can do all of the actions we need to do via the slide-in. He said we can wait for that one, so we don't have to do that part, which is good.
Excellent.
Yeah. Also, I know we discussed about the spinner. So when you're loading the diary, we were going to have a spinner on that.
Right, Jules' bit.
Yeah, so Jules, is that included in your incremental loading stuff? Or do you need to add something for it?
I am in the exact place where that spinner gets started and stopped.
Okay.
So
in V10.
In V10. So it could be part of this. I'd have to have a look and see what the differences would be in how it was implemented in V10 and how it's implemented in V11. Hopefully it's exactly the same.
Okay.
And I don't think it is. I think that they were saying they didn't like the spinners per resource, and then trying to add one for the area. I don't know whether it's the whole of the diary or just a section of could be quite difficult to do. If it's the whole of the diary, then it's not a problem, but then it sort of defeats the object of having incremental loading, because you'll see that sort of spinner over the top of it.
Okay, well, I mean, obviously we
discussions,
need
yeah.
decision on based on whether we actually want it in the first place. I assume does that come from Simon, is it?
Yeah, so we raised it before, but then obviously after a discussion with Dow, it was kind of, Simon said just slap a spinner on the screen, but then like Dow said, that kind of defeats the object of having the incremental loading. But then Dow, didn't we say that it's going to happen so quickly anyway, than just doing the spinner.
Well, no, it doesn't.
It's going to be because it's
exactly towards.
You're using small test sets, and then so the response time is quite quick. If you take one of the big databases with the pediatric intensive care of 150 people on the roster, and ask for 13 week roster, it's going to take a minute. It's not going to be significantly faster. Because it's an awful lot of data to get from the
surgical. Surgical ward, it takes about 10 seconds. And then when we go to the 26k dB on Patrick's one, that takes about, how long is that, Patrick? About 30 seconds?
Oh, something around this, yeah. It's like,
so yeah,
you need to wait some time.
It's not, yeah, it won't be fast enough to not worry about.
Most users, most of the time, using small rosters and small windows, it is quick. But it's the big contrary way you see it.
Yeah, otherwise you just sit with a blank screen and you're like, did I click that? Is it loaded?
Yeah, I think that's what this is for. This is, that's to kind of give the user some indication that the system is actually doing what it's, you have clicked the button, it's gone away to try and get the data. It just, as you said, it just sounds very counterintuitive to work so hard on getting the incremental loading done and just slap a spinner on the screen anyway and deem the diary unusable until the whole of it.
Unless it's not, because the thing is, it's how you do the spinner, because you could have a spinner, and then, I don't know, a sort of a very light grey overlay over the top with it spinning, and then you could see the data being loaded in the background.
Yeah.
And then you've got a bit of, it's we know how big the chart is.
Yeah.
Splat an overlay for the higher, the viewport essentially. Light grey, opaque overlay.
So it's a bit detailed for a front.
Yeah.
It's getting that way, isn't it? We'll need to have some discussions over that one. Peter, you mentioned your meetings most of the day, are you? Does that include a get together with Lindsay?
I've got the back, Lindsay and I are in the back of Auckland 2-3 today. I've got a session with Patrick and Nettie and Dale on the selection things are my Jupiter meetings today. As opposed to the a travel print review and a management retrospective this morning, and I've also got another design workshop session with the DNS team this afternoon.
Right, so jam pack then.
Yeah, it's not as busy this week. It's not quite as full as last week. But,
pretty much. All right. Well, I mean, as far as Team Jupiter is concerned, I guess as long as you can have that meeting.
I think that helps. I thought was the first priority was to get those things done. I'll try. I'll find time to put down a pull request in between things.
Fantastic. Okay, thank you. Is there anyone who hasn't spoken or who wants to add anything up?
Yes, guys. So I just want to update that I would be on leave tomorrow, and tomorrow I need to go for the applying for the e-pass to go back to my hometown. So if that get approved, then probably I will be on leave on Tuesday also. Monday is a holiday. It's an Indian holiday.
Monday's a holiday. You're off tomorrow. And if you get the pass, you'll be off on Tuesday as well. Okay.
Have you put them on the team calendar?
Yes, I will. Yeah.
If not already.
Hope you get that, man, because you back your family.
So Peter, what's happening is they are living in different states. So there are some relaxation in the lockdown, but still interstate movement is not allowed. So
yeah, no.
I need to go to
the
DA.
I read India lockdown news.
So I need to go to
the DA.
But that doesn't mean that it's even more important that me, you, and Dale get together at 1 o'clock today.
We can connect right now also. What experiment I was doing, that I'm done with that. So that works for me.
Okay. I've got scrums, and then we've got a retrospective. So if we can keep that until 12 o'clock. That would be useful.
Yep.
Right. I think we're done.
One last question. On Monday, is anyone working on Monday except me?
Is it a bank holiday on Monday?
Shut up. Is it a bank holiday on Monday? Oh, I love these days.
Ones that sneak up on you.
पाइथन रन करो कमांड लाइन पे पी वाई होता है
तब पाइथन
पी वाई पी एच एन
पाइथन थ्री होगी
शायद एंटर मारो दे
यार विंडोज में ना तुम्हें पासवर्ड भी सेट करना पड़ेगा शायद
एक बार ना नेट पे सर्च कर लो कि पाइथन तुम्हारी सेट हो जाए उसके बाद तुम्हें क्या करना है मैं बता देता हूँ है ना एक बार जाना जरा उस पे कमांड लाइन पे इसमें तुम्हें पहले उस पाथ तक जाना है जहाँ पे तुम्हारा जो मैंने तुम्हें शेयर किया ना
उस जो आपने शेयर किया है
कोड जो शेयर किया इन्फोसेक उसके अंदर इन्फोसेक के अंदर हाँ एक फोल्डर है लैंडिंग पेज स्टेजिंग हाँ इस पाथ तक जाना है लैंडिंग पेज स्टेजिंग तक ठीक है
लैंडिंग पेज
हाँ इसके अंदर जाना है उसके बाद जो मैंने तुम्हें कमांड दिया ना वो सारी रन कर देनी है एक एक करके
तो सब ये
मैं
रखूँगी
हाँ सब इसे
और पाइथन को वो और जो पाइथन की वो डायरेक्टरी वगैरह सेट होती है वो कहाँ पे ऐसे ग्लोबली वगैरह ऐसे कुछ बनाना
हाँ कुछ नहीं करना यार तुम्हें बस पाइथन तुम्हारे कमांड प्रॉम्प्ट पे चलनी चाहिए मतलब ग्लोबली इंस्टॉल होनी चाहिए तुम्हारे इस पे जैसे जावा चलती है ना यार बस वैसे ही जैसे एनपीएम चलता है एनपीएम कहीं भी करो तो एनपीएम आई हो जाता है ना जहाँ पे मतलब पैकेज रोटेशन पड़ी हो तो ग्लोबली इंस्टॉल
वो सारे कमांड्स मुझे मुझे मतलब जो है सीरियल वाइज इसी में कर दूंगा है ना
हां इन्फोसेक के अंदर नहीं उसके अंदर
जितने भी आपके कमांड के
हां लैंडिंग पेज
स्टेजिंग के अंदर लैंडिंग पेज स्टेजिंग के अंदर जो है वो सारे कमांड्स पे रन करूंगा एक बार अगर पाइथन चल जाता है
करेक्ट तो लास्ट में तुम्हारा ना लोकल होस्ट 8082 पे रन हो जाएगा वो जब तुम ब्राउजर में रन करोगे तो वो चल जाएगा पेज आ जाएगा वो जो
ठीक है ठीक है
मैंने तुम्हें दिखाया था
ठीक है मैं कर दूं और बस पाइथन
पे वो भी ले लिया करें
जी
यार, तो इतना दुखी हो गया ना मैं कोई
छोरा
कड़ा